you're looking for ways to have a strong why, set deadlines, and schedule the life that you want, then this video is for you.
Many of you are getting distracted because you don't have something that's stronger than a distraction. You need something stronger than a distraction.
A deadline acts as a forcing system on your subconscious mind toward achieving your goal on schedule.
I plan each hour and I probably plan each minute. And yes, it leads to way higher productivity.
What's up, Believe Nation? It's Evan. My one word is believe, and I believe in you. I believe you have an amazing gift inside you that I want to see explode out onto the world. Now, I started the Believe Life series to try to take different topics in personal development that if every week we can learn a new thing to make ourselves better, it'll allow us to live our best Believe life. So today, we're going to learn the 5 golden rules of successful goal setting. Enjoy. Up first, rule number 1 is have a strong why with Eric Thomas.
I got an older white male. He's probably in his 60s, maybe, right? And my man says to me, you know, like, I heard what you said, E.T., but how do you sustain it? I'm like, okay, say it. I'm like, all right, say it again, because I want to make sure I'm hearing what you're saying. He's like, you talk about going 120. You talk about going hard. You talk about having what you want, being what you want, do what you want. Okay, I get it. But how do you sustain it? I'm thinking, is that a real question? I said, listen to me very closely. How did I start this whole presentation off? He said, write down the people name that you love. I said, duh, if you're waking up every day and think about your wife, duh, how do you not sustain it? If you wake up every day and you're looking at your son, how do you not sustain it? You think I'm gonna put my kid's life in the hand of some other man? You think that's my role as a father? You think my role is to allow my kids to come here and pay all this money, go to school and do everything they did, and now they gotta go beg somebody else for a job? That's not my role or responsibility. How sustain it? What do you mean? How do you not sustain it? I ask you, why are you not pumped up? Why you have days off? I'm asking you why you get 70%. You don't love nobody? Is there not somebody that you don't love more than yourself? Is there not somebody you waking up for? Is it not somebody you grinding for? Somebody told me that they get distracted easy. Let me tell you something. The reason why you're getting distracted easy because you don't got 8 or 9 things you wake up to every single day and say, I gotta go get that. Many of you are getting distracted because you don't have something that's stronger than a distraction. You need something stronger than a distraction. You're getting distracted with parties. You're getting distracted with smoking. You're getting distracted with drinking. You're getting distracted with sleeping. You're getting distracted with video games. Why? Because the video game is stronger than your goal. I tell my homies all the time, bro, if it ain't got nothing to do with, y'all be playing. I'm like, if it ain't about the money, you just singing it. I'm for real. Don't be blowing me up.
Rule number 2 is set unrealistic goals with Simon Sinek.
It's easy to pull things back. It's very hard to ramp things up. And I'd rather start with something that's too big and pull it back into reality than start with something that's so easy that you can't really get it up. For example, you know, don't set your goals realistically, set them entirely unrealistically. I mean, shoot for 80 and be disappointed when you hit 70, as opposed to shooting for 20 and being ecstatic when you hit 21. We beat our goal. Yeah, but it was a very low goal. You know, I think to be frustrated and achieving something rather than ecstatic and achieving less is a better way to live. Mm-hmm. Not to mention you achieve more. I'm a great believer in that the greater good, like those things are like so big, they're ridiculous. I mean, like, you know, my goal is 100-year goal is called world peace. You know, so daunting, you know, but that's the idea. If I fail, and I certainly won't achieve it in my lifetime, I like to think that what I'll contribute towards that ridiculous, idealistic, nonsense goal will be more than if I say, if I can just be happy by myself in my little house, you know?
Right.
I mean, that's nice and all, but
that's good.
I like the idea of contributing to your neighbor as well.
Rule number 3 is set deadlines with Brian Tracy.
The third step is setting a deadline. If it's a large goal, set a series of sub-deadlines. And what if you don't achieve your goal by the deadline? Set another deadline. Remember, a deadline is just a guesstimate of when you will achieve it. You may achieve the goal well in advance, or it may take you much longer than you expect. But you must have a target time before you set off. A deadline acts as a forcing system on your subconscious mind toward achieving your goal on schedule.
Rule number 4 is schedule the life that you want with Jordan B. Peterson.
Do you plan your day much, or your time generally? Does this lead to higher productivity? Yes, I plan my day obsessively. My calendar is always absolutely full and often weeks in advance. And I plan in the morning, especially when I'm on top of things. And I plan each hour, and I probably plan each minute. And yes, it leads to way higher productivity. You know, you decide what your goals are going to be. You place them in the calendar. Use the calendar as your friend, eh? Because what you want to do with the calendar is design a day that you want to have, or a day that would be good for you. And a day that would be good for you is one that you're, when you end the day, you feel that you've moved yourself ahead towards your valued goals, and that you've kept chaos under control. And that enables you to sleep soundly and with a good conscience, and to know that the next day is going to be at least not worse than that day. Planning is unbelievably useful. And again, you know, I don't want to sound like a broken record with regards to the future authoring program, but it really is useful. You know, you need to figure out what it is that you're aiming at and why, and then you need to figure out how you're going to break that down over the months and the weeks and the days. But I would approach your calendar like it's your best friend. You think, okay, I'm going to design a week, man, that I really want to have. And that means you can schedule in leisure and all the things that you want to do, which you absolutely should do. And it's also quite fun to give yourself minimal time to do something complicated, because it's quite challenging to see if you can do far more than you thought in far less time. And so that's a fun game. And the other thing you can do is, like, if you're avoiding something, you could schedule in 5 minutes of it and say, well, like, if you're avoiding looking at some bills because you're afraid of them, you know, your first step might be to schedule in 5 minutes where you just look at the bill. You don't do anything else. And, you know, you might be able to entice yourself into doing that. So, but I would say learning to plan is unbelievably useful to schedule your time, because that's your life, you know. But schedule the life you want. That means you have to schedule your responsibilities off, obviously, because responsibilities are those things that ruin your life if you don't fulfill them.
And rule number 5, the last one before the bonus, is make regular progress with Thomas Frank.
So a couple of years ago, a friend told me about a novel idea that he had. It was this big, grand vision that would take him a really long time to write, and he knew it, and in his defense, he did start working in earnest on it for the first few days after having that idea. But as you could probably guess, after those first few days, his motivation waned, and he stopped working on the book. Now, when this happened, we didn't want to see him give up on the project, but one of the suggestions we gave him was to first cut his teeth on some smaller projects, maybe work on some short stories or some blog posts, just something to basically get him into the habit of writing regularly. But his response to these suggestions was that he didn't want to waste his time on these smaller projects. If he was going to write, he only wanted to tackle his grand vision. And this happens to a lot of people when they set big goals. They don't want to detour from their grand vision to work on something a bit smaller. And this mindset, as well-intentioned and determined as it may seem, is one of the biggest reasons why people fail to achieve their big goals. Far from being a waste of time, these detours from your grand vision, which I like to call intermediate goals, are actually essential for helping you build the skill set you need to actually execute on that bigger project. Essentially, no matter what the goal is that you've set, you need to be able to see regular and tangible progress being made. Otherwise, your motivation is going to wane and you're going to stop working on it.
Now, I've got a very special bonus clip on goal setting with Denzel Washington that you want to see. But before doing that, the question of the day is, I'm curious, what is your biggest tip for goal setting? What is the thing that you have learned the most that has helped you plan goals for your business, your life? Leave it down in the comments below. I'm really curious to find out. Thank you guys so much for watching. I believe in you. I hope you continue to believe in yourself and whatever your one word is. Much love. I'll see you soon and enjoy the bonus.
Dreams without goals remain just dreams, and they ultimately fuel disappointment. So give yourself goals, you know, and remember that between your goals and achieving your goals, you must apply discipline and consistency. And put your slippers way under your bed at night so that when you get up in the morning, you got to get on your knees in order to reach them. And when you're down there, say thank you for all that you've been given. like the breath of life, family, friends.
So let me give you the one word secret to happiness. One word. This is all you need to be happy.
The most important word ever.
If you had to think of one word that's most important to you or that sums you up or that would be kind of like a little beacon.
Hey, Believe Nation, if you want to know what the most important one word is for Tony Robbins, Gary Vaynerchuk, Oprah Winfrey, Will.i.am, and Howard Schultz, I have a very special secret video for you. Check the description for details.